of Contavious Towns. He was loved by many, adored by many. And today we are definitely going to celebrate him in all his glory for what he's done for all of us and in us. We are not going to mourn him today. We are definitely going to celebrate him. He was lively, so we are going to be lively for him in today. Ain't that right, family? Ain't that right, family? Yes, yes. We thank God for bringing us here today from far and wide. And we are going to show him the love that he showed each and every one of us. Amen? Amen. All right, so to start, I'm going to read a scripture. And this is from Psalms 9. Oh, yes. Please silence your phones. Please, we don't want any interruptions, and we are streaming live here. And I'm going to start by reading a scripture from the Old Testament. This is going to be Psalms 9, 9 through 10. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble, and they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. For thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. And from now, we're going to go ahead and we're going to have a New Testament scripture read by Shanice.
The New Testament scripture is from Isaiah 41:10. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious hand.
All right, from here, we're going to go ahead and have a prayer read by Danielle.
Eternal God, our Father, we come now, God. God, we ask you, God, first that you forgive us, God. We ask you, God, that you forgive us of sin, God. We come now, Lord God, on behalf of this family, God. We ask you, God, that you wrap this mother in the hollow of your hand, God. We ask you, God, that you, Lord God, wrap, Lord God, the mother of his children in the hollow of thine hand, God. I ask you, God, that you even comfort his children. I ask you, God, in the name of Jesus, that you touch this family. God, for in this life, there are things that are uncertain. But God, we pray to you, God, because we know, God, that you are one thing that will never leave us nor forsake us. God, I ask you, God, that you walk into this very room. I ask you, God, that you comfort these hearts on today. God, we need you in this very present time. So I ask you, God, that you move by your power. I ask you, God, that even after this day that you walk with this family, God, be their God, be their Lord, be their Redeemer, God. Touch now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, whenever everybody leaves, God, I ask you, God, that you even rest on that bed, God. I ask you, God, that you speak louder than ever, God, in the name of Jesus. I ask you, God, even by the power of the Holy Ghost, that you never allow them to experience this tragedy this way again, in the name of Jesus. I even bind the hand of the enemy. Devil, I tell you, you are a liar, and I tell you to go back to the pit of hell from which you came from, in the name of Jesus. God, now we glorify you. God, we lift you high. God, we elevate you over everything that is trying to take control of this atmosphere, in the name of Jesus. God, so we bless you. God, we adore you. God, I tell you that I love you. God, I tell you that we need you. Save somebody's life on today, God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we do pray it. Amen.
And now we're going to have a special selection sung by Shanice.
I've had some good days, and I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days and lonely nights. But when I look around and I think things over. All of my good days, they outweigh my bad days. So I won't complain. Sometimes my clouds hang low, and I can hardly see the road. So I ask the question, Lord, why so much pain? But he knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes cannot see, so I'll say, thank you, Lord, and I won't complain. Because God has, he has been good to me. He's been so, so good to me. More than this world could ever be. He's been so, so good to me. And he'll dry all of your tears away. Turn your dark nights into day. So we'll always say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And I won't complain.
Kentavious LeVar's Town was born September 10th, 1997 in Chicago, Illinois, to Erica Littlejohn and Kenyatta Towns. Kentavious completed his education at Horatio May Elementary School and Academy of Scholastic Achievements. He worked at K&T Movers and the Better Men Foundation, where he was a top employee. Kentavious met Dashika Christmas June 15th, 2015. And during their relationship, two children were born that loved him dearly. He was everybody's favorite. He was always willing to help his family and friends, and he had a spirit that would bring happiness to the entire room. He loved his kids, his nephews, and his nieces. Kentavious was preceded in death by his grandmother, Dorothy Towns, his great-grandmother, Mercy Harris, two aunts, Shirley Porter and Vita Towns, and best friends and brother, Man. Kentavious leaves to cherish his memories, his mother, Erica Littlejohn, his father, Kenyatta Towns, Bree, his grandmother, Gwendolyn Littlejohn, his love, Dashika Christmas, two children, Chase and Chloe, two brothers, Devin, Tasia, and Kentarion, six sisters, Tata Nisha, Chanel, Lativa, Janelle, Kenya, and Kentavia, 14 nieces and nephews, aunts and uncles, and a gang of cousins and friends that loved him dearly. At this time, we're going to have remarks from family and friends. We would like you guys to please line up, anybody that wants to speak, and we want you guys to limit it to 2 minutes, please, for time's sake.
Can I go first?
Absolutely. At this time, we're going to do the slideshow first, and then we're going to line up to do remarks. Thank you.
the squares that you light up. We don't mind the butter, but you big bro with the title. Now you got me on some obstacle with the rivals. It's only Phoebe Davis. I know some niggas dropping down for a penny. But I'ma keep it silent, cause them niggas they snitch. A couple niggas they bitches. Got a little bone queen, knock it down when you live. They say we living for tomorrow. Tomorrow, too many times, you live in sorrow. Some families praying for the hollow. So I thank the Lord, he ain't asleep. This a hard pill to swallow. All these echoes. Oh, I'm feeling all these echoes. And I heard four try to save me. Hit a home run like baby.
Thank you.
This time we can have everyone line up that wants to give remarks, and please keep it to 2 minutes.
Hello. If y'all don't know, I'm Deshika Christmas, the mother of his two kids, and I just want to get up here and bring y'all back to the day before. We went to a silent party. It was Tavis' first silent party. He was in there. He was having a good old time. A good old time. He kept telling me, "Bae, we should start doing stuff like this more often." I'm like, "Yeah, I told you they was lit. The lit parties, the silent parties be lit." We went home. He bought 2 ounces of weed. Sorry. He bagged up. We smoked a blunt. We ate some breakfast. It was like 4 a.m. I will never forget it. We went to K and King's on Chicago, on North Avenue in Laramie. He got him a burger. I got me an omelet. We banged that stuff. We laid down. We went to sleep. He held me when we went to sleep. Oh, Lord, forgive me. Lord knows I love that man. I met him in 2015. That's all I know. I remember so many days. We slept on the floor together. We was broke together. This man was selling tires. Selling everything, candy bags, all types of stuff to pay that rent. He did not care. Whatever cuz had in that trunk, he was gonna sell. But most importantly, I know he loved everybody around right now. And I just want to say I love everybody. Because you could be here one day and gone the next. And I try not to blame myself because I feel like if I would have called off of work, he would have been woke. But when I left out for work, I just left. I didn't wake him up. Usually he'd call me, be like, "Damn, babe, no kiss." Lord Jesus. I just want to say, Tavis, I love you. Man was the one who put us on, if y'all don't know. I was walking to the store. Let me tell y'all this story real quick. I was walking to the store, being fast. Man was like, "Hey, Q, check it out." I'm like, "Huh? What these niggas want?" You know what I'm saying? I walk back. He was like, Keys, he called me again. Keys, check it out. I go over there. I was like, what you want me, man? He was like, I don't want you. Someone on this porch wants you. I'm looking around this man. Like, I'm like, I know they don't want me. So I look at Taylor. I'm like, he on the phone with a girl. I'm like, this nigga. You know what I'm saying? So I went to my granddad's house. I walked past. I had 30 cent, y'all. I went to the store to get a juice. Just being fast. I just want Tavis to see me again. That's all that was. I got his number. I walked past. He was like, damn, no curfew? I was like, I'm grown. What you mean? You know what I'm saying? I wasn't grown. I was there a little bit of 15. I wasn't. But I just want to say I love everybody. We here together. And yeah, that's all I got to say.
Before we do have the next speaker, so everybody can see, if I can have like three people line up here and then the rest of you all, if y'all can stand on that wall, when three people get done, three more come, just so we can have everybody to be able to see. Thank you all.
My name's Dyson. I love my Uncle Tavis.
I'm glad you got your V-Bucks on Friday. V-Bucks? Come on.
Look.
Hi, my name is DJ.
Hey, DJ.
Yes, I'm a DJ.
What I'm about to say to Tavis is that he's been taking care of all of us who's in our family, and also he's been looking out for us, and also he's been taking care of us ever since we was little. My granny, there's a picture of her. She's been looking after Tavis too and been taking care of him. And she was thanking him for being a wonderful person and being great. You didn't say it.
How everybody doing though? I'm doing good. I'm doing great. I just want to say one thing, man. I was just at the studio last night, and I'm just sitting in the car by myself, and my car, Tavis the last person to drive my car. He was the last person to drive my car, so you know how Tavis, he goes right to the store, buy his little smell goods. Man took my, he took my cologne. I'm like, he got my cologne. He put some smell good in them. I'm just sitting in the car, so the car smell good. I ain't smoked in the car, nothing, you know. All I smell is a cigarette. I'm like, bro, I look to the side. So you gonna flame up a score again? I'm not, it's crazy. Tavis flame up a score in my car at all time, and I tell him not to. He don't care. Damn, bro. Damn, one. This just one square. He just flamed up three of them. Come on, but that's all I wanted to say, man. I miss my little brother. I know he in a better place. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got too much to say. You know. Love y'all too. I love y'all too.
He loved that song with the TikTok in it. He loved that song. He loved that song.
How y'all doing? I'm Miss Auntie Linda. I'm gonna miss my nephew. I miss my whole lot. It's a shame you take Tim to die like my mother passed. It's for all of us to get back together. It's a shame. don't want that bullshit. Excuse me. We ain't been seeing each other. We ain't been seeing each other. Don't tell that damn lie. We haven't been seeing each other. I ain't been telling none of them. We ain't been seeing each other like we supposed to. We have a family reunion. Because everybody, we ain't dead, we multiplied. We started having babies. We's coming together like we supposed to. Tell each other down. I love y'all.
How y'all doing?
Right.
Yeah, it's so much I can say about my close friend, Catavius Towns. Like, he was always fresh when I saved him. And bro, he was always getting money. And bro, he always wanted to shoot dice.
And
bro, man, it's so much I can say about this man, Joe. I can't really say nothing bad about the man. Like, I only remember good memories about him. Oh, bro, like, he always made me laugh. Always, like, I call, he coming, period. Oh, bro, like, that's a good person in that casket right there. Oh, bro. Y'all, oh, bro. I just want y'all to remember him as a, you know, good person. Like, not a sad thing, because he was a good person. Right. Thank y'all.
Good afternoon, everybody. My legal name is Bernita. Contavious referred to me as Miss B. We are here standing strong from Ready Chicago, his last employer. My most fondest memories of Contavious, he came to our program in the midst of the pandemic, so it was pretty much virtual. He used to say, Miss B, why you always on me? Because I know your potential. And I know the journey that you're on. All of us here walked hand in hand with Contavious on this journey. Whenever he did come to in person, he come through the door. My main concern was, pull your pants up. I shouldn't know what color your underwear are. The last conversation I had with Contavious was the Friday prior to the Angels coming to get him. And he was in our office and he called me from one of our staff members' phones, fussing. That job never called me, Miss B, in about, I said, Contavious. Yes, ma'am. Contavious, did they call you and you missed the appointment? Yes, ma'am. He said, Miss B, but I deserve another chance. I said, you do. You deserve a second, a third chance, just like I gave. Yeah. And I emailed them. Mm-hmm. And then Monday morning, they emailed me back. Of course, Contavious can come for another appointment. But he had another appointment that he needed to be at. We love Contavious. When Contavious came into the program, he signed our heart, and that's where he's going to stay. He's in a better place. From the Ready Chicago family, we love him. You all have our support. And just like with any other MVP player, we retired his vest with some photos. And just so you all know, he'll never be forgotten. And we love y'all with the love of Christ. If y'all want to say something else.
My condolences to everyone. I was his coach. Every morning we used to do a check-in. One being the lowest and 10 being the highest. How you checking in? Yeah. I'm at a soul buck. I'm at a soul buck. And that's how he gonna always be here in the soul, as a soul buck. All time high. Thank you.
Man, what can I say? I'm Les. I know him from the job and from the streets. I run the 12 o'clock program that he in for his work experience where he get paid. And we used to have the discussions about transitioning from the streets to doing something better. And he was one of the most outspoken people that, you know, that boy there gonna tell you how he feel. That's one thing about him. But what I'm gonna miss most about him is seeing the little Chloe feed him them potato chips. You know, she fed him them potato chips online. He biting. I said, man, and I told him, I said, you know what? You don't see too many young fathers nowadays that step up to the plate.
That's right.
And I said, man, I want you to know, I don't care what nobody said about you, player. You're a great father. Right. And I wanted him to know that. I wanted him to know that. So I just want him to know, nothing went unnoticed, bro. You still in our hearts. We love you forever.
Hey, everybody. My name is Kenya. I was Kentavious YDC, his coach. He called me his mentor. That warmed my heart. Every day I talk to Kentavious. And it's going to be so weird. Starting this Monday, it was so weird not talking to him Monday through Friday. But every time I spoke to him, he spoke of you and his family and them kids. He loved them kids dearly every day. That's how I know that he truly, truly, deeply loved y'all. And I do want y'all to remember that and to keep saying his name, keep him alive, because he is alive. And you, y'all have y'all memories. He's alive in them kids. And he will always be in y'all hearts. And Kentavious, he was a light. I put it in the letter that he was a light. And he was the funniest dude in the room. Yes. Anytime he was on them calls, I say, Kentavious, stop cursing. You always cursing so much. He was like, people not acting like they got common sense. I said, well, common sense ain't that common. He's like, I'm gonna let them know. I'm like, all right, we gonna figure it out. But he was such a good person and a light. And I miss him dearly, and I know every one of you all would miss him dearly as well. And I'm always here, just like I told him, I'm always here whenever y'all need me. Thank you.
My name, Quincy. Some of y'all may know me as 4J. Little bro know me as 4J. May they introduce me to y'all as 4J. Did y'all hear me? Okay. I don't know. I'm somewhere else right now. Yeah. Is it in there? There it go. Okay. But nah, my name Quincy, though. Y'all probably know me as 4J if little bro introduced me to any of y'all, though. But I ain't gonna lie to you, the first time I seen little bro, he had like the brown in his hair. You remember? boy, why you got that in your hair? he say this my new style. I say it's okay, it's cool, bro. Yeah, if that's what you like, that's what you like. I'm gonna rock with you though, bro. But it, man, though, little bro, like, that was like our little last Phoebe member, though, like, but he acted like he was the one that made Phoebe, though. You feel me? Like, for real, though. I'm talking about he always got a plan for us to do something. You feel me? Like, the bro was smart, though, bro. You feel me? We always had long talks, man. I'm talking about from the hospital to house arrest everywhere. You feel me? Like, little bro was a star, bro. You feel me? And I kept telling him that. That's why, you feel me, like, latched on to him like that, because I felt it in him. You feel me? I'm like, little bro, you ain't like everybody else, though. You a shorty. You ain't even my age. You feel me? Like, you a shorty. You ain't even my age, though. But you don't need, I don't come at you like you a little brother type, like a look. You see what I'm saying? Like, it was always love, though. Little bro always had his doors open for us, bro. Like, Fire's a gang, though. You see what I'm saying? And him, I told him, like, the day we go to Lil' Co thing, when he was shot up on the picture. Hi. Yeah, you can't, y'all can't leave me. How you gonna go to a party you shot up, bro? What you gonna do? You didn't want them to go.
I didn't want them to go.
Listen, okay, listen, somebody listen. Cutie blowing the phone up. Now I gotta go try to take you. No, I ain't finna do that, little bro. It's bussing right now in the party. You stay all the way out west. Why? No, man, you shouldn't have gotten the car, bro. Oh, now my stomach hurt. My staples hurting. Come on, little bro. Go on here. We finna call you an Uber, bro. We not leaving the party, though. You shouldn't even came, for real, though. He say, man, I gotta be there. I'm Phoebe. Yeah, you is Phoebe, bro. For real, though, man. But yeah, though, I'm just saying, though, I got a lot of love for Shorty, though. I got a lot of love for her. Phoebe got a lot of love for him, though, man. And you feel we gonna miss her, bro. You feel me? Y'all put some respect on little bro name, though, man. For real, though. You feel me? Let that be known to everybody that ain't in here. Yeah, don't ain't none of that. When we see y'all, when y'all see them and they want to do this and they got love, y'all, they had love, they would have been here. You see what I'm saying? Or send something else and let it be known. You see what I'm saying? We don't do that fake stuff, though, bro. You feel me? But I love all the family. I don't know. It's a lot of y'all, and I don't know all of y'all. You feel me? But, hey, lock in with me, though. I'm cool. I love y'all, love.
Y'all know what I'm saying. His drunk cousin. I'm drunk, kind of a little tipsy now. The last time, man, if you be kicking, was Friday. The last Friday, I was just helping my boy wash his dishes. Why not? We sitting right there washing the dishes. He washing them. I'm rinsing them off, drying them off. I was so drunk, I don't even remember. But I know my girl, she told me, like, you know you gave him a kiss that night on the cheek. And he told you, like, go on, cuz, go on home. Your girl, she ready to go. I was just so drunk, man. I just miss my cousin so much, man. I don't really got nobody to kick it with now. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. My best friend locked up. My right hand man gone. I ain't really got nobody to kick it with, but I'm gonna keep it up. I'm gonna keep my head up and stay strong for my boy, because I know all he want me to do is chase the sack.
Love.
Hey y'all, I'm TT. I want to read my poem for me and my siblings. To our brother, the day you left us and gained your wings, our heart just broke into pieces. We wish you could have stayed with us, but heaven needed you. You left us with the memories. You left us with the memories and worries. We love you no matter how much time goes by. You know we always will. You a great brother. Full of love and laughter. You ain't play about your siblings. You ain't play about the family, period. We know we can't bring you back, even though we wish we could every day. But a piece of us left when you did. I love you forever. I'm my brother's keeper.
Hey, y'all, I'm Leo. I'm his crazy sister now. Y'all don't understand. I love Tavis. Like, y'all don't understand. That's my brother, bro. I love him for real. Like, he my real brother. It hurts so fucking. It hurts bad.
We love you,
Mel. Oh. Hi, everybody. I'm his oldest sister. Well, I'm all they oldest sister. But I just want to say, like, I love my brother. Like, y'all don't even know, like, If anybody knows Tavius, know he asking you for $20 soon as you step in that door. I don't care. And I'd be like, brother, you got more money than me. He'd be like, man, sis, I'm asking you for $20. But
he swear he'd be broke.
Right, be broke, right. Has stacked like rows of money. And we like, boy.
Yeah.
But, you know, that was Tavius. He was a hustler for real. Like, that, and I'm like, who am I call for everything now? Like, you want something, call Tavius. He got, like, okay. Like, I'm going to miss my brother, though. Like, I'm going to miss him. We all going to miss him. I love him so much. And, you know, I love y'all, too, so.
Love you, too, Chanel.
Love you, cutie boo.
Hey, I'm Bridget. I'm cutie sister. Like, Kentavious was like a real brother to me. Like, and it, for me to be the older, he was like my big brother. Like, one thing that I always remember, even if I was in a relationship or not, he made sure he got me something for Valentine's just so I wouldn't feel left out. Like, no matter what, every year he got me something. And I never asked or none of that, and he just did it just because he loved me, just because he loved my sister so much. Even aside from that, just because of the bond that we had. And it's just so crazy because, like she said, I could call him for anything. It's like a flat. I'm like, I don't care, especially a flat. Like, but anything, though, anything really, though, but Kostoff, he got me. He gonna come. And it's just like, oh, my God. It's like, I feel for my niece and my nephew. I feel for my sister. I feel for Erica. I'm so sorry that we all had to go through this. And I'm just going to pray for us and pray for everybody.
Hey, everybody. My name Marvin. I'm Tavis' little cousin. You feel me? Like, my cousin, I love the man. You feel me? We had our ups and our downs. We had our good times and our bad times. Anytime it was a problem, I called my cousin. He was coming. You feel me? Any issue, I called him about, he said he going to handle it. And when I called him the other day, he told me he was going to handle something for me. I was waiting on him to call me back. He never called back. I've been wondering when he was going to call. He didn't call. And it's like, I really love the man, and it's crazy that he had to leave. Real life. Every day the man on my mind. And I really can't stop thinking about it. That's all I want to say.
So, as y'all know, as Tavis right there, Nuki, when Tavis is always crying or something, Nuki will always have his back for him. Or whenever he's mad, he will make him feel better. Also, whenever Tavis hurt himself or he ever gets scratched or like into a fight, Nuki will always try to make something feel better. Also, Martiti right there, she always have been taking care of Tavis whenever he don't have nowhere else to go. And also, when he doesn't get anything, my TT will always give it to him.
Love you, DJ.
All right, at this time, we're going to have a soloist come up named Sam. He's going to perform for us.
Hello, how y'all doing? I'm doing good. Y'all all right? We gonna be all right. Yeah. Help is on the way. Help is on the way. All right, I'm gonna sing and I get out the way. Hey, praise him. Hear the music. Disappointing you, so I need to talk to you and ask me for your guidance, especially today when my life seems so cloudy. Guide me until I'm sure I open up my. Dreams are fading fast. I'm all burnt out, and I don't think my strength's gonna last. So I'm crying out to you. Lord, I know that you're the only one who is able to put me through, so I need to talk to you, and ask me for your guidance, especially today, yeah, yeah, guide me until I'm sure I open. Do the things you do. Don't let me make the same mistakes over and over again. Your will be done, and I'll be the one to make sure. Talk to you and ask me for your guidance, especially today, when my heart's so cloudy. Guide me until So tell me, can you stand the rain? Storms will come, this we know for sure, yeah. Tell me, can you stand the rain? Can I minister to your spirit just for 1 second? Storms will come, this we know for sure. Tell me, can you stand the rain? Can y'all sing it with me? Storms will come, yeah, this we know for sure. Tell me, can you stand the rain? Y'all gonna make it. We gonna make it for real. Praise him.
Now we'll have the eulogy ran by Prophetess Danny.
I want to do things the way God showed me when my sister called me on the phone about her brother. And they seem to believe in me. I believe in myself, but they seem to believe in me. So I stand before you, and I don't know anybody in the room. But what I do know, as this child of God that sits in this casket, he reminds me a lot of my nephew, and some of you all may know him. I don't know if you all know Bolo. He died in a car accident. That's my nephew. And a lot of things that, oh, Jesus. A lot of things that they said reminded me of my nephew. And I want to tell you, I know how it feels to lose someone suddenly and not know that he's going to die. Mm-hmm. I can remember that I was in Florida for my birthday. I've already lost my father. I moved back to Chicago. I'm from Holy City. I moved to Georgia for 10 years, and God showed me that my father was going to have cancer. Mm-hmm. And when it started getting worse, I had to move back to Chicago to care for my father. My mother's sitting right here. That's my bodyguard, y'all. Mm-hmm. She checking for me. So I knew my father was going to pass, right? That I did know. So I would sing to him, I need thee, oh, I need thee, every hour I need thee, oh, bless me now, my Savior, I come to thee, I need thee, oh, I need thee, every hour I need thee, oh, bless me now, my Jesus, Savior. That's what you got to do. Uh-huh. We need God in this very hour. We live in a world of uncertainty. Nobody knew the gas prices were going to go up to what they are. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that's going to protect us and keep us and provide for us is God. Amen. There are a lot of things that are unsure in this life. I'm pretty sure that this child here didn't know that she was going to lose her man. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure this mother did not expect to be sitting on this row in 2022. Mm-hmm. But I call him the goat. That's what I kept saying in my head over here. That's the goat, right? He loved money, right? I seen somebody in here trying to put money in his pocket.
I put $80 in his pocket. Are
you in the room? You fine, but was somebody else trying to put some money in his pocket?
Nope.
Nobody? What I want y'all to do is come put some money in her hand.
Oh, I put it in his coat.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Listen to me. Because God is telling me to do some things. See, that's my brother. He like money. I like it too. So I'm gonna listen to me. Listen to me clear. He gone. He can't do nothing with it. He can't do nothing with it. You got his babies. He took care of them, right?
And that's something that I want every man in here that's a father to listen to what people said up here about him. He gone, carry it on. When y'all think about him and you see her, put something in her pocket. My nephew's favorite phrase was, pimp, put it in my pocket. Y'all can take it, y'all can put it on the shirt if you like. Put it in her pocket. I don't really want to preach. I don't feel a preach word in me. Because the guy up here, he had on orange. I think he left. He already did. He said, put some respect on his name.
Can I see?
Put some respect on his name.
Most definitely.
Y'all, the sisters over here, make sure they put some respect on his name. While y'all putting respect on his name, put some respect on God's name. Learn to have a reverence and a respect for who God is. Because one day, we all going to leave here just like he did. And to be able to get where he is, you got to know Christ.
Amen.
See, I don't care about nobody smoking weed. My friends call me the hood preacher. I'm from Holy City. I didn't ask to be a prophet. I didn't ask for my daddy to be a pastor. I didn't ask for the mantle to get passed down to me. But it's a lot of people in here, and I ain't going to call you out because I don't got time for that. It's a lot of people in here that got a call on their life. You, sir, you got a call on your life. I pray God not that you fix your bed. I ain't coming to play today. I ain't coming to, you know, I ain't got the Lord said, but I do got the Lord said. And he said that you're going to make it. You shake your hand, sir. You shaking one from one millionaire to another. You're going to make it. You already got a hit song. Put it out. I hear it. It's in my head right now. Uh-huh. What is it? Somebody sing.
The song with the TikTok. What
did
he say? Jesus.
Voices.
All right. Yes, that's Tavis.
Yeah. Yeah. You can count on it. Tell him, Mom, if I tell you something, you can write it and eat that it don't erase. My guy used to call me, come get the stuff from out the back of the house.
Yes.
So I ain't just a minister that's talking to y'all that don't know what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I done been kidnapped before when my daddy was looking for me. Yeah. So I had to go through everything I need to go through to be able to talk to y'all today. If I didn't go through everything, I've been raped from 3 years old by my older cousin. Why you call me, and here's some hurting people in this room. God, I ask you that you take control over this atmosphere, whatever it is. I bind it now in the name of Jesus. God says, cast your cares upon him because he cares for you.
He blew it. If you want a man to respect you, respect yourself. I don't know why I'm here. I don't know why I'm talking like this, but it needs to be said. I ain't even mad that you cussing, but just stop cussing so much, thank you. You like money, right?
Yes, ma'am. Money, man, yo.
It's good to like money, it's not good to love it. The love of money is the root of all evil. But money does answer all things. It answers all things. It does. So us people that's in this room, God has allowed certain things to fall in our lap for a reason. He ain't allowed it to fall in our lap to get the latest Jordans all the time. Put some up. A wise man leaves an inheritance for his children, children, children. When my daddy left me a building. I'm living now, I don't got to pay no rent. When I move, I'm going to move and I'm going to have me a house. I suffered loss. I had my husband walk out on me, but God showed me 3 days before he did that he was going to leave. Start asking God to give you some discernment because he'll show you some stuff. He'll show you. But when he show you, you got to go with what he showed you. I almost lost my man that man walked out on me. Country. I go down to Georgia, very country. Close and lock the door, baby. Lock the door. Give me that. It took me 6 to 7 months to even be able. I had to sleep in a closet. I had a big old beautiful house. My mom would tell you. Right. I experienced church hurt too. I was married to a minister. But it ain't the church, it's sometimes it's the people. But that's what God said. I wish she could have talked to him, you know, because he walked out and y'all heard what you said. He left me. Me and my three kids, he wanted the father of them, but I thought I had family and I ain't shining on them. And I tell y'all, everything ain't certain. Even being married, things are not certain. Friends will betray you. That's why I'm telling y'all to get y'all some discernment. Fall on your knees and ask God to show you. Amen. Show you your enemies from your foes. You'll be surprised when he shows you. And you ain't even got to let people know that you know. Because God will swipe them out. But when they leave, stop telling them to come back. So he left me. I had to leave my home. I had to leave Georgia. A lot of people, they want to move to Georgia. A lot of people want to move somewhere else, move away from here. Because of stuff that's going on. I'm telling y'all about uncertainty. At church, people, they ain't ask me, did I need food? Did I need anything? And I used to be the one that would give up $5,000 to the church. Stop me when I'm lying, mama. I'm telling y'all about uncertainty. I could have lost my mind. I don't look like it. So I came back here to Chicago. So then, if this man would have walked out long, I would have had no time with my dad. My dad took care of me for 37 years of my life. I ain't never had to pay a phone bill. I ain't never had to pay, stop me when I'm lying, okay? Got a 2019 Volkswagen truck. It don't mean that I couldn't pay for it. I had a father that knew what it was to be a man. So 37 years, I knew what a man was. These babies, they need to still be able to experience that. So those of you that's part of this family, step up. Step up. Trust me, God will tell me your address, and you'll be like, why is this crazy lady up in front of my house as I told you what you're supposed to do? So after that, what you need, baby? Ah, Jesus. This baby, whose child is this? This your, whose child? This your baby?
Brother's nephew.
He either going to be a president or a scientist or something here. He's very smart. Scientist, that's what it is. All right, don't take him with you because he's throwing me off because I'm like, ooh, geez. Give me some money now. You know what I mean? You're a prophet, God gonna always take care of you. If you give the a prophet a glass of water, you'll receive a prophet's reward. The prophet's reward is your health. You ain't got nothing wrong with you. And if you do, God gonna hear you. So do what God's telling you to do. Uh-huh. All right, uncertainty. I won't be before y'all too much longer. But uncertainty, right? So I started off and I told y'all I went to Florida for a convention. You will not suffer depression. You will not find your friend in a bottle. Uh-huh. I see what I see. It's okay. The Bible said the sin is not getting not drinking is getting drunk. So you'll be sober minded. You got them kids to take care of. And I ain't judging you because people get on my nerves in the church sometimes. Sometimes I want to drink some Hennessy. And I ain't going to tell you whether I do or don't. Ain't nobody business. What I will tell you is this. Things are uncertain in this life. Amen. But the only sure thing is Christ. Amen. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. He said that he will be with you until the end of time. So if you don't know Christ, I don't even know if I'm supposed to leave you in the plan of salvation now or if I need you to let go home in your own room. Too much. Is that coming from him? Close your mouth. He's telling me to tell y'all that. Through the Spirit, that's Holy Spirit, but it's through his voice. I hear his voice. Stop talking so much. Everybody ain't your friend. Do he talk like that?
To me, at least.
Jesus. He's telling me to tell you that everybody ain't your friend. Uh-oh. To forgive you. Ask him to forgive you of your sins. You must first believe. You must first believe that he lived, that he died, and you believe that God raised Jesus from the dead, you say, I've spoken in your ears now. You can repeat it. Lord, forgive me of my sins. Y'all say it now, whoever it is. Lord, forgive me of my sins. Guess what? If you die today, if you die today, and you ain't told God sorry, baby, when judgment comes, you're going to burn. Hell is hot, it's real. Just like the tea people be sipping, gossiping, talking about people. But they can't clean up their house, they can sit on the phone and be talking about somebody else's business. While I'm on that topic, God gonna deal with y'all too, slandering people's names, making up stuff that ain't true. God gonna deal with
it. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. So if you're in here, I want you to know it's sin, just like you sipping tea and it's hot hell, hot tea. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't want to go to hell, it's hot in here. Mm-hmm. I want to see my daddy again. Amen. I want to shake his hand. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, ask God to forgive you of your sins. Mm-hmm. Every day, before you leave out your house, mm-hmm. Jesus. Somebody got to pray. Mm-hmm. For this faith be met again. Mm-hmm. And I told you, if I tell you something, you can mark it in ink, that it don't erase. Somebody can go get the funeral director. Mother, it's going to be all right. I told you. Did she give you my phone number? Can you get the funeral director? Where's she at? All right. If anybody looking for a church home, it's on the south side. It's by an old block, but we good. We from out west. We ain't worried about nothing. 5400 Champlain. Y'all got the flyer. And spell my name right at the top. It's wrong at the bottom. Danielle House. Y'all find me on Facebook. Baby girl, find me on Facebook. Rim. Danielle House. You connect with me too on Facebook. I've seen you before. Maybe I've seen you in spirit. You gonna preach at conferences. Somebody in here got a cold line they're supposed to do too. It's you. Look at that. This boy walking back. You have to. All right. Y'all find me on Facebook. Brother, you shake your hand. You hold your mama up again. Hold up. Y'all hold up. It's okay to cry. It's going to be all right. So, yeah, we done now.
Good afternoon, friends and family. As we prepare for our review, we ask that you remain in your seat until I get to your row. After you view, can you so kindly return to your seat? The pastor is going to do the benediction, and after that, we will close. Amen? Amen. Can I please have some music, please?
And I ain't no pastor. I'm just a minister.
I mean, the prophecies.
Yeah. So how he talks with me, yeah. So how he tells me that I am his own.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, all the glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away to glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away to glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. I shall wear a crown, crown. I shall wear a crown, crown. When it's all over, when it's all over, I shall see his face, face. I shall see his face, face. When it's all over, when it's all over, is I shall wear a crown, crown. I shall wear a crown, crown. When it's all over, when it's all over, I'm going to put on my robe, tell the story how I made it over. I'm going to put on my robe, tell the story how I made it over. Soon as I get home, soon as I get home, soon as I get home.
Thank you. I shouldn't have asked y'all
on behalf of